Madam Chairperson, distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen, actually thanks UNSDR and all delegates present for this opportunity to share our experience and to highlight areas we believe renewed efforts are required if the global DRR community is to rise to the mounting challenges posed by climate-related and other hazards. It is now widely acknowledged that disasters play a central role in contributing to destructive cycles of hardship, increased vulnerability, and growing poverty. ActionAid's work on DRR in 16 countries across Asia, Africa, and the Americas plays a key part in our fight against poverty. In 8 countries across Asia, we have been implementing risk reduction and disaster preparedness programs since 2004. These programs have focused on building national and subnational capacity to address the risks faced by communities, facilitating community-centered and managed DRR through social mobilization, and placing DRR at the heart of national development policies. Our pioneering 5-year disaster risk reduction through schools project, implemented in 9 countries, sought to institutionalize DRR efforts within communities by using schools as a locus for working with children, teachers, parents, local officials, and other key stakeholders. This innovative approach also provided strategic opportunities to integrate the Hyogo framework for action priorities within national education systems. Our experience on DRR has highlighted the success of 2 areas of work we believe require greater investment and commitment of DRR efforts at local, national, and international levels. And these are, 1, the need to build comprehensive resilience based on an analysis of all factors driving vulnerability. And 2, the need to put women's leadership at the center of resilience building and DRR initiatives, acknowledging the breadth of experience they already possess in relation to DRR and climate change adaptation. In light of this, ActionAid calls upon UNSDR, national governments, multilateral agencies, local authorities, and civil society networks to invest in comprehensive resilience programs and initiatives which promote and facilitate women's leadership as a central component of disaster risk reduction and climate change adaptation work. Now, in order to build comprehensive resilience, the global DRR community must, 1, ensure in-depth analysis of the multiple underlying causes of human vulnerability and thus the root causes of disaster. 2, we must engage a variety of key people and groups in the process of identifying and addressing vulnerabilities whilst keeping vulnerable communities at the center. We need to tackle vulnerabilities at different levels, from local to international, ensuring interventions always focus on the needs, demands, and knowledge of the most vulnerable. And we also must promote initiatives which seek to combine local knowledge with climate science, enabling communities to identify sustainable measures to reduce their vulnerability based on an appreciation of the latest available scientific information. And finally, in order to promote and facilitate women's leadership, the global DRR community must, 1, recognize that women are on the front line of the impacts of climate change and acknowledge the existing capacities and experience for actively contributing to and leading DRR and climate change initiatives. We must ensure women's concerns and experiences are voiced through their participation in vulnerability assessments and the implementation of the identified priorities of action. We also need to ensure that women are formally represented at all levels in implementation and decision-making forums for DRR and climate change adaptation. And finally, and as a priority, we must dedicate and allocate funding for DRR and climate change adaptation initiatives which promote and protect women's human rights while facilitating their role as leaders in their communities. Madam Chairperson, once again, I wish to thank you very much for the opportunity to share these experiences. Thank you.